Cloud computing and the cloud is a common term used to describe data and software services that are stored and running on servers in some remote location from where they're used. Clients, which include web, mobile, and traditional desktop or server computers, then access and use this data and the set of services, most commonly using the internet or some sort of VPN connection. Now, this doesn't sound much different than having your own server somewhere, and in reality, it's not. The difference is in who controls and manages the servers where everything is stored and running. And that's the cloud host provider. They pay for and manage all of the equipment and keep it all running and updated, and you just simply use their equipment. So who are these cloud providers? Well, the answer is a lot of companies. There are big companies like Microsoft, Google, Apple, and Amazon that have a lot of resources and products that people use every day. We also have smaller, dedicated companies like Dropbox and SugarSync that offer very specific services to clients. And finally, enterprise services companies like VMware that push their commercial products to the cloud to make them more accessible. But why should we be taking advantage of these services offered by these providers? And the answer is, as with anything else, money. Most companies and people need to store data, and the question is, where do you want to store it? To create your own server that's backed up, always available, and kept up to date is quite expensive, both in time and money. You've got to have a physical place to put the hardware, pay for the electricity and the cooling, and then have to work out how to get your data onto that server, keep the operating system and tools all updated, and work out a backup plan so that you don't lose your data. And as your data needs get bigger, this gets even more expensive. For example, even though every data center is a little different, the average cost per year to operate a large data center for an enterprise is usually between $10 million and $25 million. That's a lot of money. And so a lot of enterprises have begun to shift toward cloud computing to utilize data centers operated by somebody else, where they manage the infrastructure for you, they pay for the electricity, they deal with cooling, they deal with keeping that system online and available 24/7, and we simply push our data up to these servers and use those servers. This saves us both time and money because we don't have to manage any of that infrastructure ourselves. The National Institute of Standards and Technology have defined five essential characteristics of cloud computing. The first is that there's broad network access. That means you can reach these resources from a wide selection of devices and systems, such as PCs and websites, smartphones, and IoT-connected devices. Now, this doesn't mean that the resource is available over the internet. It could fit this definition and be accessible only through a corporate network or a virtual private network. The second characteristic is that it's on demand. The resources are provided on an as-needed or when-needed basis. Consumers of the resources only pay for what they consume, and so you have a pay-as-you-go model. The third characteristic is that the system pools resources. In other words, the provided resources can serve multiple clients or customers with a provisional or scalable sort of model. This is often accomplished through virtualization, but can also be done through higher level management of the provided services themselves. Next, it provides rapid elasticity and expansion. This involves dynamic provisioning of services and on-demand self-services where customers can change their levels of service without actually contacting the service provider. For example, with Azure, some services can actually be automatically scaled by defining rules or thresholds where Azure will check and automatically provide more or less of the resource as needed. Next, and finally, it has to be a measured surface. This is where the provider monitors the service for various reasons, including billing, effective use of resources, or overall predictive planning, and they provide this information back to the client so that they can make decisions about how to actually use the provision service.